A very good morning to all of you students. I hope everything is going well with you. Organs of government, unit number 10, we have already started. It is little bit long unit, that's why it takes lots of, or we can say many videos here. Today we are going to start another topic of the same unit, that is executive. Bill, legislative, legislative council, legislative assembly, that we have discussed earlier. Today's topic is executive, the function and work of executive, purpose of executive, and what are the powers executive has in their side. That is discussed in this video. Please keep a textbook with you. The most efficient, effective, and central organ of the government is the executive. Union executive means central government. Here we have union executive, and union executive, it means central government. Political executive comprises administration of the prime minister and cabinet of ministers, president, vice president, and bureaucrats. Political and administrative executive officers and employees are in direct contact of the people. So it is these executive officers and it is the political members, those are the direct contact of the people so that they can solve all the issues of people. The people are influenced by their work. The executive implements the law framed by legislature. The legislature frame the laws that we know. And those laws are implemented by executive. The administrative executive carries out the work of implementing the policy, programs, and planning done by the government, keeping in view the aspiration and expectation of the people. So this executive's work is to implement the policy, to implement the law, to implement the program, or to implement the planning of the government. And at the center of the purpose, means motto of this executive is to complete the aspirations and expectation of the people. The political executive changes every 5 years or if the power is given up. Whereas the administrative executives form permanently appointed bureaucrats and hence it is permanent. So there are two types, that is political executive and administrative executive. However, the retirement age of administrative bureaucrats is different in different states. So see, this political executive changes every 5 years. So this is change in every 5 years. And administrative is like permanent. Retirement age of executive bureaucrats is different in different age. So this it is different from different state. before their retirement, if they misbehave or shows lack of efficiency to work, they can be removed from their post after following prescribed inquiry procedure. If this administrator, executive, behaves badly or misbehave, or if they show lack of efficiency in their work, so they can be removed from the post after following prescribed inquiry. The political executives are the members belonging to any political party. So what about this political executive? So they are, this political are the members of any political party. Public choice and public opinion, whereas administrative executive requires education, qualification, quality, experience, as well as passing competitive examination to be appointed permanently. So talking about this, so this we have, in this we have, we need educational qualification. It must be passing the competitive exam. Degree and all must be there. Administrative executive. So this requires degree. This is a permanent place. This requires education qualification. This requires special expertise in special field. This require passing competition exams too. Here, while political executive change in every 5 years, retirement age of this both are different, and this political executive members can not have any specific criteria for that. This member of can be from any political party. That is the difference between political executive and this administrative executive. The service of the administrative officer is known as civil service. At the center, the political executive consists of president, vice president, prime minister, cabinet of minister as per constitution. So this services of this administrative executive, so that service is known as civil service. I mean, the work of this administrative executive is known as civil services. Okay, you might have heard about the civil service exam, that is IPS officer and all. Okay, please you note down this. After that, we'll go for president. See, here in political executive, we have president, vice president and all. Those are including in political executive, and here we have IPS officer, IS officer, collectors and all. Now, most important organ of government is president. Thank you. President is the constitutional head of India. I am the constitutional head of India, so that is President. All the executive powers of the federal government is given to President by the Constitution. All the administration of the central government is carried out in the name of President. He is the head of the nation and first citizen of Republic of India. Here we can say, first citizen of Republic India. Now, what are the qualifications we need for President? So, qualification. A presidential candidate should be a citizen of India and should be 35 years of age or above. So prime requirement or prime qualification is he must be a citizen of India and he should have the at least the age of 35 or more than that. So first of all, citizen of India and 35 years of age or more than that. He should not be salaried employee of the government or hold any office or profit. He must not have any office or any profit. He should not be a member of any of the House of the Parliament or State Legislative Assembly. The presidential election is indirectly carried out by the members of both the Houses of the Parliament and the members elect to State Legislative Assembly. A president is elected for a term of 5 years and he can contest the election after the completion of his term. So another requirement or qualification of president is he should not be a member of any house. The presidential election is indirectly carried by the members of both the house. So both the house member decides who will be their president. A president is elected for a term of 5 years. So he or she can be elected for another 5 years if after completing the term. When the president is in power, neither criminal case can be framed against him or an order of arrest or imprisonment can be issued. When that president is in power, means when that president is on duty of a president at that time, not a single criminal case can be framed against him. So, no criminal case, or we can say arrestment, framed against him. as he is the head of India or head of the nation, or we can say the first citizen of the Republic India. Please you note down this. After that, we will go for functions and power. Means which powers and function president has. Now, functions and power. What are the functions and what are the powers a president has? Let's see. He appoints the leader of the party who has gained majority in the general election as a prime minister. Then, with the consultation of the prime minister, he appoints the other minister of the cabinet. So, he appoints the leader of the party. First power of president is he appoints leader of the party. Then with the consultation of prime minister, he appoints the other minister of the cabinet, as well as he appoints other minister of cabinet. He administers the oath and distributes the portfolios to the minister. So he administers the oath. So oath and distribution of portfolio. As long as the cabinet enjoys the support of the majority members of Lok Sabha, and the president cannot dissolve the cabinet. So that is not in president hand, that if majority of the Lok Sabha is in one favor, so president cannot dissolve that. President is the head of defense force of the country. He is the head of the defense forces of the company. The president has the power to declare war, cease the war, and conclude treaties with other countries. This power he has. Declaration of war. Cease the war and conclude the treaties. This power president has in his hand. He appoints the judge of the Supreme Court and High Court, governor of the state, attorney general, comptroller and auditory general. So this appoints, he appoints this, he appoints most importantly judges of Supreme Court and High Court. Not only that, but he also appoints governor of the state, attorney general, comptroller and auditory general. He appoints the head of the defense force. He also appoints the head of the defense force. He appoints the chairman of Union Public Service Commission and ambassador to the various nations. That is in his hand to appoint the chairman of Union Public Service Commission. Thus, vast authority, executive and administrative powers are vested in president. He can grant pardon, reduce the sentence of any convicted person, or can postpone its implementation, or can change the nature of the punishment. See, that is the important power that president has. He can grant the pardon to any criminal, means convicted person. He can also reduce the sentence of convicted person. He can postpone the implementation, or he can also change the nature of punishment. Suppose any criminal has a lifetime sentence, so president has power to reduce the punishment of that criminal. If any criminal is just given that lifetime imprisonment or that punishment of death, so president has that power to reduce or to pardon that convicted person. So that is the very important thing. Let me write. He can grant pardon He can reduce sentence, means here imprisonment, sentence of a criminal, or he can change the nature of punishment too. He summons the session of both the House of Parliament and prorogue them. He can even dissolve the Lok Sabha if the president is satisfied that the security of India or any part of its territory threatened by a war or external aggression or armed rebellion. He can declare a state of emergency for the whole India or any of its part. So first thing, another thing is he can dissolve the Lok Sabha. So Lok Sabha. So now you can see, student, that how powerful president is, how this organ of government, president, is powerful. Please you note down this. Still we have many powers and functions of president. He can also declare the emergency at the time of war, at the time of attack of any other country, and he can also declare emergency in whole country as well as any part of the country. That power president has. The declaration of emergency cannot be challenged in court. Based on report of the governor, the president can declare constitutional emergency in the state. He can establish precedent rule by dissolving the state cabinet ministry. In the case of financial emergency, the president can reduce salaries of government officials, including judge of Supreme Court and High Court. So he can also declare constitutional emergency. Another thing he can do is, at the time of emergency, he can reduce the salary of that officials. Though the president has vast executive and administrative powers, and though all administration can be considered in the hand of president only, done in his name only, in reality, president and council of minister enjoy this power. So this prime minister and council minister can also enjoy their power, though the power of administration is there in the hand of president. And see, he can establish precedent rule too. So this is the president, and now it's time to give you homework, and your today's homework is, see, very important body president is. So I am in homework, I am giving you write a detailed note on president, including qualification, powers and function of him. This is asked in 4 marks. So you have to write all the details of the president which is given in your textbook. We'll meet again in next video with Vice President and Prime Minister. Till then, take care. Bye. We'll be right back.